But mine does kind of combo in with the other two tips we have gotten. There, as the great philosopher J.G. Wentworth says,
oh, gosh.
It's my money, and I want it now. And what
you're off to a good start, Mike. I'll be honest.
We've got Bathilda Bagshot and J.G. Wentworth bringing you the fantasy knowledge you need.
We bring the deep cuts to win on the fantasy footballers. And what I mean by that,
I'm feeling so.
Are you diving deep now to find a good one?
I'm great now.
Is the guys I'm taking late in the draft, I want to know immediately, does it look like they have a path to value? And it's especially strong for running backs because guys like Peyton Barber going extremely late in drafts, you're going to know, at least for a chunk of the season, you're going to know week one, is Peyton Barber the guy or are they going to try and force it to be Ronald Jones? If it's Peyton Barber, you're going to have a nice value. The offense should improve. Bruce Arians has done magical things with his running backs. And now you have a nice value with Peyton Barber. Same with Matt Breida. What's that split going to look like between Tevin Coleman and Breida? Is it close to Burita's getting 40%, but he's hugely involved in the passing game? Devin Singletary, what happens to LeSean McCoy and Frank Gore in front of him? Justin Jackson. If Melvin Gordon is holding out, Justin Jackson should provide value early. And on top of that, I'm not looking that it would be great if these guys turn into season-long values, but I'm trying to get my team off to a hot start, and I want to know who can help my team right now. And you know what they also help? They help if they do nothing, because now I know I got the easy cut. It's not a problem. I don't see a path early on in the season that these people are going to provide value, unlike John Brown. If John Brown comes out and has a bad week one, it could just be the factors of the game. I still got to hold on to John Brown and find out.
Do you feel like Devin Singletary fits that category of guys you'll know in week one? Because I would imagine this season starts with Frank Gore getting all the veteran love, the pat on the booty.
I'm drafting Devin Singletary because perhaps LeSean McCoy gets – there's still the rumors that Shady McCoy is going to be traded before the season starts, and then – watching week one, it's not necessarily that Singletary puts up a huge fantasy performance, but I look at the snap counts, I look at the usage. Does it look like Devin Singletary is going to rise to the top of that depth chart quickly? That's what I'm talking about.
Sure.
And I mean, like Golden Tate, you can draft him late, but now I'm sitting on
more
this
like
player.
Golden Wait.
Oh, so good,
Kobe. Oh, that was nice. I just. These wide receivers, where you take them late, they have a bad week one. You don't know for sure that they aren't going to be involved in next week's game.
All you know is that some unknown wide receiver will score 3 touchdowns in week one, be sitting on the waiver wire, and you'll be like, oh, man, do I drop John Brown to go grab Kirby Mershewich?
I thought you were going to go with Kirby Puckett.
Darnell Anderson.
So I want to know right now, are you going to help my team for the first 25% of the season? And that's what I want with my late shots. I don't want someone to sit on my bench for 6 weeks to figure it out.
No, that's a super important tip. I fully and wholeheartedly support J.G. Wentworth on that one.
Oh, hey. I was just doing some heavy research. It's the research that makes the fantasy footballers great. Click that subscribe button and find out more.